So check it out. We rented this amazing RV for the weekend and we're heading out to a really cool place called Cotillion Gardens. It is in the Santa Cruz Mountains in Felton. I have never been there before, but I'm super excited. I can't wait to go there and experience a really fun place. Let's go. Let's tour the RV we got for the weekend. Starting out with beautiful sink. We got cupboards up here, a microwave, cooktop. There's no stove. Here's one of the couches that will turn into a bed. Up here will be another bed. There is a TV. DVD player. Up front, controls. Big table, seating for six here. Looks like if you just push down, the table goes down. Goes flat. You can set it up for a bed. Got the refrigerator. Freezer. Huge storage area. Closet. The bathroom. Cabinet. Skylight. Vanity with the shower. Some little hooks to hang on. Got the light. The pop out is not out right now, but there's the pop out area for the bed. Skylight. Can't wait. Time to load it up. After packing everything up the night before, we got an early start, which was obviously way too early for Paige. And we had about a 3.5 hour drive, which we stopped once to give the dogs a little potty break, but we made really good time. I would say overall, this RV was pretty easy for me to drive. I didn't have many complaints. Unfortunately, my Google Maps kept rerouting me to the road that I was told not to take, and we ended up taking Highway 9, which was not recommended for larger RV vehicles. This section right here wasn't as bad as it gets, but it kind of reminded me of the road to Hana over on Maui. Luckily, I live in the mountains, so I have a lot of experience driving on squirrely roads, as I like to call them. So I was right at the limit and we made it safely. Although the turn into the campground was very hairy and I stopped traffic for a moment and had to back up a couple times before we actually made it down the driveway. It was pretty stressful. Cotillion Gardens RV Park and Campground is this lovely family-oriented and pet-friendly campground. It is nestled in Felton, which is in the Santa Cruz Mountains, surrounded by a redwood forest, located right next to a creek fed by the San Lorenzo River. It also conveniently backs into the Henry Cal State Park. After getting settled in, we decided to take the dogs for a walk around the campground and give you a little tour. The campground offers partial and full hookups for your RV. There's also tent sites and some cabins. There's also a pool and even a clubhouse that you'll get to see in a little bit. Of course, I didn't miss out on the important stuff, which is a tour of the bathroom, which has two toilet stalls and a shower stall. And I must say that the bathroom stalls are the tightest I've ever used in my life. but they work. Just don't forget the door code at like 4:30 in the morning like I did when trying to use it, otherwise you'll have to walk all the way back to your campsite. According to the map, there are over 80 spots. We stayed in campsite number 71. There's about two or three campsites for tents, and we saw four cabins that you can rent. It was definitely a tight squeeze for all the campsites, but the way they're laid out, it didn't seem like you were on top of each other so much. We never ended up going swimming in the pool because it was always crowded, but we wanted to. Who can pass up a good old-fashioned slide? Not me. We decided to channel our inner childhood and have some fun on the playground. Overall, the vibe here was super chill and positive. I would love to come back here again and book a few sites with family and friends. After realizing we didn't have enough firewood, we jumped in the car and headed into the town of Felton to go get some firewood and other snacks and drinks and supplies that we needed for our trip. We found this amazing natural foods grocery store, which was just what we were looking for. We definitely couldn't resist some of this lovely fresh fruit. I ordered the corn empanada and had it heated up, and it was so delicious. I don't know about you, but I am a huge kombucha addict. You guava be kidding me. Isn't that cute? So we had to grab this mushroom chocolate, some Bolt Energy, some Lilikoi chocolate from our favorite place of Hawaii, some kombucha, and some protein almond drink, and some jelly from Santa Cruz. As we drove by, we decided we had to go check out this little thrift store. Time to head back to the campground and prepare dinner for the night. It's just so beautiful here, I would never get tired of the view of these gorgeous trees. My daughter Brooke set up a puzzle, and my other daughter Paige and I started the barbecue with our handy dandy gas barbecue. After dinner, we stayed out as long as the light and the lantern would allow and worked on the puzzle. After a while, it gets too dark to check out any of the shades, so it's time to pack it up. Who's ready? I'm a little nervous, but let's do it. So we found this beautiful retreat in the mountains of Felton called Mount Hermon Adventures. Back in 2010, Mount Hermon Adventures began with a vision to provide people of all backgrounds a quality, authentic, and inspirational experience in the outdoors using challenge and adventure experiences. They believe that bringing groups of people together in a safe space, inviting them to try something new and exciting, and helping them reflect on their experiences is the best way to make our world a better place. We chose the Redwood Canopy Tour. It is a 2-hour guided eco-adventure tour that included 6 zip lines and 2 sky bridges at heights of up to 150 feet, and I felt every foot of it. Each tour of up to 8 people is led by 2 tour guides who share ecological knowledge and bring the forest to life. I happened to be on a tour all by myself because the group that booked with me had to cancel at the last minute. This was such an exhilarating experience exploring the redwood forest and learning all about the trees. I will be back.
We have a little trial run to do a practice run so you get used to the gear. Oh,
okay.
Before we just hack you out into the trees. First thing, we're going to go over the trolley, the little guy you're actually carrying up. Go ahead and take a look at that old guy, little red guy.
Okay.
The way you will use that today is you won't. So you are welcome to carry this so it doesn't like whack you on the kneecaps. Okay. But as far as like the clipping, please just let us be the ones to clip it onto and off and stuff. So that being said, that means your most important job while we're out there is looking good.
This. However you do it, just so long as you don't come into the other platform, spread eagle.
Okay.
So it's your turn to zip one hand up top, one hand
there.
On that bright green. Perfect. Forward.
Okay.
One. Try to take one more.
Okay.
Perfect. Sit down in your harness. Lift your legs.
Woo! Ta-da! Nice, stuck the landing on the top too.
Whoa.
That was perfect.
Yay.
Nice job.
Yay. Oh, I love this entry. This is very cool.
Very Jurassic Park-esque.
There you go.
We have one more piece of gear to go over. Those are the noodly pieces of fabric that are hanging down from the front of your harness.
I'm not moving.
Leave the clips to us today, but from these buckles down, all this fabric and webbing stuff, this is all yours.
Okay.
You can hold on to this, hold on to the railings, your choice, or nothing at all.
Okay.
And cross on over.
Okay. Woo!
Balance.
Thank you.
When you're ready, I have to head over on this side.
Like you said, though, the first one's a hard one.
Yes, this is scariest, not the longest, fastest. Yes. So remember, you're gonna have one hand there, perfect. Other one on top, excellent. And then you're gonna zip along. I'm just gonna give a big old wave, and you'll hand off, and you can take your top hand and put it next to the other one on the right ring. Baby step.
Okay.
You're gonna sort of sit down in your harness, squat down like you're in a lazy boy chair. All right, then you're just gonna lean back and lift your legs and float away.
Woo! Onto the very top for me. This is here. Nicely done. That was absolutely perfect. But remember, you are clipped in, so you're not going anywhere.
So. Alrighty. I'll take hold of that. What you can do now is you can reach for this cable right here with one of your hands. And then you're going to take a few little baby steps forward and up.
Break step. Please clear.
Have you ever seen Peter Pan?
Yeah.
Or Hook?
Maybe? Yes. Okay. Yes.
I love Hook. Well, just like Peter Pan or Hook, when you're going to be zipping along this one, your shadow will be flying through the forest. So if you want to try to find your shadow and wave at it, you can do that. Good job. Yep. And a few little babe steps down. I know, they're tiny steps. I promise the next tool is better.
Okay.
All right, you're going to sit down in your harness, lift your legs, and off you go.
She can fly!
Woo! Perfect! Nicely done!
Thank you!
Nice job!
I'm actually glad there's not other people because
yeah.
Then I don't have to be paranoid about body parts around me.
You're
like
all good.
Sketched out.
Come on over, Jordan. Yeah, hey, you looked down. Dude,
I did.
That's a big freaking deal. That's a big deal. Do not underestimate how cool it is that you did look down on this one, too. Especially
yep.
for people who are a little nervous when it comes to height.
Yeah, I'm good.
Plus, the first one's the scariest one. So.
Right, right.
We are also 140 feet up on this tree. So
I know this one's a little bit scary because you can't see the other platform. I do promise it's on the other side. That's why Emma went first.
Okay.
Woo!
Down and forward.
Ooh, okay.
Doing great. You're gonna sit down, lift your legs, knock you down.
Ta-da! Very nice. How was the ride?
Fabulous.
Awesome.
Did you know that redwoods are one of the oldest species of trees and were once the dominant tree in the northern hemisphere? There are three types of redwoods: giant sequoias, dawn redwoods, and the coastal redwoods. The coastal redwoods here need the cool, foggy summers and mild winters this climate provides. While it doesn't rain much in Santa Cruz from June through November, redwoods can receive up to 10 inches of water during this period from fog condensing on their needles and dripping to their shallow roots below. Coastal redwoods are the tallest trees on Earth. The current record holder, a tree named Hyperion in Humboldt County, measures in at a staggering 379.3 feet tall. That's taller than a 37-story building. Redwoods can reach ages over 2,000 years old, with trunks up to 24 feet in diameter. Redwood trees were logged heavily through the mid-1900s, and entire forests were cleared of trees. Today, only a small percentage of the original forests remain. Most of the forest at Mount Hermon is second growth, though some original trees remain. Even though I'm deathly afraid of heights, I pushed through my fear and I just enjoyed every moment of these trees and all the beauty and majestics that they have to offer.
this up gently. Sit down, lift your legs and up you go.
Woo! We made it, yay! On the way, we saw the mystery machine from Scooby-Doo, and I just happened to be wearing a Scooby-Doo shirt that day, which was so awesome. Next stop, time to reward ourselves with some libations and food at the Cowboy Barbecue and Grill.
Can I get the upstream salad, please?
And then we'll get the yam cakes, okay. And I'll have the luau ombre burger.
Cool. I'll do the cran apple salad, please, with the chicken.
With the chicken on it.
The zip lining was awesome. Now it's time to go on another fun adventure and do a little hiking in the woods.
Since this park backs up to the Henry Cowell State Park, there are plenty of trails to explore. We found a trail called the Felton Pipeline Road Trail, and it's a terrific trail for the entire family, including your tail wagger. Since the trail is within a California state park, there's always some basic rules that you will have to abide by if you come with your pooch. First, you must always keep your pet on a leash. And it's also a good idea to carry some cleanup bags with you to help keep the park clean. The trail usually has moderate traffic most of the time, so if you're looking for solitude, you're better off using one of the other dog-friendly trails in the park, such as Meadow Trail or Graham Hill Trail. This is a 5.9 mile trail, but we only went about 2 miles. It runs along the river and it's pretty fairly even. It just has a beautiful view of the river and all of the trees everywhere you look.
Yay.
Oh, that was so fun.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. Yee, so cute. Just got two kids in a playground right now. She still got it in her. Yes, she made it to the top.
Yes, nobody's playing.
I'm so glad we had pockets full of quarters and the place was empty. We had it all to ourselves. It was a blast playing all these fun video games and basketball, and most of all, pool was super fun. Who else loves air hockey as much as we do?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner, Paige.
Stopping at the Heavenly Roadside Cafe. Our last stop of the day is to visit a dog-friendly beach called Seabright State Beach. I actually am lucky enough to have grown up many years in Santa Cruz back in the 1970s and 80s. So I love coming back and visiting the beach. It makes my heart so happy. This beach is about a half mile long, so we decided to take the dogs for a walk over to the lighthouse. Seabright definitely delivers on everything important in a beach. While it may not have the flashy attractions of the boardwalk or the unique wildlife of natural bridges, Seabright might just be the best classic beach hangout in town. The beach even stays open until 10 p.m., giving you time to unwind and enjoy a bonfire after a full day at the beach. Santa Cruz enjoys two beautiful lighthouses, and though the Walton Lighthouse is less known than its counterpart, the Santa Cruz Lighthouse and Surfing Museum, it is noteworthy on its own right. It was constructed back in 2002, and the structure stands over 40 feet tall and weighs in at 350,000 pounds. It is built to withstand 250,000 pounds of wave energy. Although there has been other structures here over the years, this one was put to use and dedicated back in 2002. I love that this beach is a fur baby friendly beach, so don't forget to bring your loved ones down. Thanks again for watching.